Hello, this is Tom Fredrickson with the Victorian Woodshop. We're going to talk today about our custom framing option for any of our brackets. We can also do it on our gables and bracket buddies as well. But we're talking about framing. And it's not a traditional look for an old true Victorian home. They weren't really using frames back in the originals. But it has become so popular over the last couple of decades that I find myself making more and more of the frames and wanted to put up a specific video on it. Now, it's not a project that you should be afraid of if you'd like to do it yourself, but sometimes it's easier just to have me do it when you're ordering the brackets, and I certainly understand that. Now, I brought out one bracket today as an example of frame bracket. This is item number B78, a beautiful bracket, by the way, with a custom framing design on it. Now, keep in mind that the framing does add to the overall dimensions of the bracket. And in this particular case, you're looking at about 2.25 inches going down as well as across. So keep that in mind when you're doing your measurements. It's an excellent way to beef up a larger post. A lot of the posts that we have today are traditional 4-inch posts on your porch. But the older ones were 6 and even 8 inches is not uncommon. And in that particular case, you're looking for depth and bulk up there. And this is a great way to do it. I cut them at 1 3/4 inches wide so that it just matches the standard 1-inch bracket perfectly. It's a way to take a standard bracket and give yourself a little more oomph on that post that you're trying to jerk up. Another, one of the biggest reasons people order them is ease of installation. I pre-drill a hole on either end, 2 screws and they're up. I try to add some details to them. I brought one out. Now I cut them at a 45 degree angle so that when I put them together, it has a nice detail up there at the top. And then again, it's one of those things that you notice when you're walking by, so I try to do that. As well as doing a bevel on all the sides so that it catches light in depth. And that's, I hope it shows up in the video. Kind of see right in here to where the light hits it, you're going to get shadows and you get a nice three-dimensional look to the bracket. Another nice detail. I brought one out today that's just plain wood for contrast to kind of illustrate just a little bit. And when I mount them, I use glue and nails to mount them. And then when I'm done, I take a bead of caulking, clear caulking or white caulking on that, and then prime over that so that when you get the bracket, it all looks like one solid piece of wood and you can just paint over that and away you go. So it is a really nice detail. It's a way to beef up a standard bracket. Then again, it's not necessary, but it's a particular look that a lot of people are going for these days, and I want to go ahead and make sure you have all the options for you when you're deciding what to do for your project. When in doubt, go with what you think you would like to have. And I think that's the best advice I could give you. If you have any questions on the framing, please do give me a call. That's what we're here for. And then again, we can do that to any of our brackets as an option. For right now, this is Tom Fredrickson for the Victorian Woodshop.